Hello and welcome to the 8th issue of fractalforums.com news. Oh, I think I need to switch the calendar paper. Oh, this seems to be the June image, but we are in May right now, aren't we? So, let's back what to the nice image by Alex H. Now we're ready to go. The 6th annual Fractal Art Competition submission period is running from 1st of May until 1st of June. Everybody is invited to submit up to 3 entries in each section. As every year, the winners will get their winning images printed on a coffee mug. This year's sponsor is the Center of Transition Sciences from the Universidad Autónoma Metropolitana in Mexico City. The contest has 3 sections: film, still frame, and as a varying section, we have the axolotl section this year. Already now, we have promising entries, but why not judge for yourself? Every film entry needs to be of 5-minute length. Also, we like to see the annual Fractal Art Competition 2013 mentioned in the clip. This movie creates an atmosphere of a big machine with well-synchronized sound effects. Arthur Stammet mixed 2 of his videos to form this new one. Both videos were made with Mandelbulb 3D. It seems to be a mix of manga sponges and other hybrid fractals. The camera perspective zooms out and shows nicely the self-similarity of the object. Also remarkable, the sound is entirely produced by the artist's squeaking door, that obviously needs some oiling. He arranged the squeaking in complex rhythms and under and overlying sounds. This jam session of his squeaking door is then synchronized to the visuals. The second video really has an outstanding beginning. It's genuine how the transition from the real world to the fractal world is made. It is called the World Builder and is rendered using Mandelbulb. The little poem at its beginning really seems to capture the spirit of fractal forums. For anyone who wonders what goal this community could have, the journey is the goal. Hesitated by these great videos. Remember, taking part is everything. So, send in your videos. The second section is for still frames. This section has had the most entries in the past years, and this year is going to be a tough competition as well. This image tells a story of the ongoing search for the Holy Fractal Grail. It really captures the fascination of the Mandelbulb, especially the coloring is done with a lot of hand work. It is downloadable in poster size and freely distributable. It is called The Discovery of the Mandelbulb by user Matzer. This ocean view is called Life is Purposeless by user Dinkydau. The whole piece is one single fractal flame made in apophysis, no imported images, only color adjustments in Photoshop. Other than that, a raw fractal. The idea to use fractals to create a non-fractal looking image is a fractal avant-garde. It was mastered nicely here. It requires lots of knowledge and endurance. Just a pity that the fishes are not axolotls. The Holy Grail by Johan Andersson is a photography of a real grail created with a 3D printer. In its center you see another tiny grail. We admire how many fractal references are hidden in the image. A little Mandelbrot is hidden in the dust on top of the book. The Romanesco broccoli is easier to spot. All livings in this picture were eaten and tasted delicious. Retro Geometrics stands out from the crowd for its retroness. On first sight, it does not even look fractal, though it is made with a fractal program. The bent chessboard in the background hints that a complex number multiplication was being used. User Trafassel entered this great close-up of the Mandelbulb called The Snake and the Wheat. It's a great proof that the Mandelbulb never gets boring. Luis Markoya's oil painting Forms of Dusk is inspired by this fractal. Its parameters are attached, in case you care to see the front view. Luis Markoya has worked with Dali, and I have the feeling it shows. Broken and Burnt by John Smith is a classic 3D fractal. It uses nearly all the most recent features of Mandelbulb 3D. Iteration fog, depth of field, reflections, and global illumination. Alex H. has a special talent for creating photorealistic fractals. This one is called Down the Petri Dish, another example of the tremendous use of the recent additions to Mandelbulb 3D. Besides the global illumination feature, although the effect called bokeh is responsible for its extreme realisticness. User Dinkydau reminds us with the Mandelbrot S that 2D fractals, and especially the classic Mandelbrot, have still not lost their fascination. This image was rendered in Fractal Extreme, and the effect is created by fine-tuning the color gradient. The last image is called Oblivion by user Tahion. The strong background lighting of this hybrid fractal and the wide camera angle gives fascinating impression. This lookout for the competition was very promising. The only regret is so far no one has used the latest feature of Mandelbulb 3D, volumetric light. But there is still lots of time left. The third section of the competition is dedicated to this year's sponsor. The task is to build an axolotl out of fractals. An axolotl is an amphibic creature that has remarkable properties. For once, it can decide for itself to stay juvenile or grow to adulthood. And furthermore, all of its extremities can regrow after injuries or complete losses. The axolotl is native to Mexico City. Our sponsor is a Center of Transition Sciences from a university in Mexico City. The center focuses on hybrid sciences. Fractal Forums found the center's attention because of its mix of art and science. Our administrator, Christian, is invited for a second time to the Vanguard Science Congress. He would be delighted to present our sponsor an axolotl image that might become a logo for the Center of Transition Sciences. This challenge has almost been unanswered up till now. The technique of layering fractals could be one possible approach. This show is the anniversary of Chaos TV. The first issues of Chaos TV reported on the fifth competition last year in all its details. By the way, the last year's winning video, Follow Me by user Taurus, has been reused by many people for experimenting. In total, it reached more than 1 million views and is spread all over the net. The winning image, the Infinity Set, has become an internet meme, featured on several art sites for its genuinity. This anniversary marks the beginning of a new season. From now on, Chaos TV will be named chaosTube. We want to avoid a name clash with the German channel of the Chaos Computer Club. The CCC is a hacker-founded awesome institution located in Germany. Next news is about... You might have heard about the Oculus Rift, available as developer kit. It is a 3D head-mounted display device with zero reaction latency. This technology is welcomed by developers all over the world. User Marius has extended his Boxplorer2 software to allow exploration of 3D fractals using the Oculus Rift. The last news for today is about an incredible speed improvement for deep zoom Mandelbrots. The user Mr. Flay has successfully applied the perturbation theory for rendering deep zoom Mandelbrots. The idea of the perturbation theory is to have the exact solution for the calculation of a point, and with the help of the delta function, we can calculate other solutions for the surrounding points. User Mr. Flay has given the proof of concept by providing us a Java implementation of the algorithm. Users of the forum compared its calculation times with the so far fastest Mandelbrot rendering software called Fractal Extreme. The Java program called Superfractal Thing was more than 40 times faster. With this idea, it will be possible to render ultra deep zooms with a combination of CPU and GPU. The CPU will render a single point with a desired precision. The GPU can calculate the surrounding pixels, only using single floating point numbers. We will report on this development as we believe it will have deep impact on the world. That's it for today. Oh, a breaking news. And let's just see what it's all about. And it made it right to the show. Let me check it. And yes, is it about the Holy Grail, the Holy 3D Fractal Mandelbrot? Yes, it is. And has it been found? No, it hasn't been found. But the search is still going on, and especially user Aleph is trying out fantastic new formulas, and user Crum is trying to implement a Mandelbrot formula using unitary numbers, but he is struggling with the addition since unitary numbers are all numbers with distance 1 to the center. Perhaps he managed to extract an addition formulation from a higher dimensional object. And we keep you informed about that. That's it, and you see me next time.